In a world with VRChat's SDK installed, we can come down to VRChat Examples Udon Program Sources, and we can see a bunch of example Udon scripts provided by the VRChat devs for us to learn from. Today, we'll be looking at the script Button Sync Owner. This script, when set up, will allow us to hit a button to increase the number shown on some text. Something to note about the script is that it doesn't show the number until the button is pressed for the first time. It also doesn't allow anyone but the owner of the object, which in our case is the instance owner, from increasing the value of the int. Allowing others to also change the int is addressed in the example scripts button sync anyone and button sync become owner, which I'll be covering in another video. Now, if we open up the script, we can see that it's split into two parts, one for updating the value of the int, and the other for updating the text to display the new number. To do so, they have created two variables. One is a public text variable, while the other is a synced int variable. The text value will contain the text that we want to change, and it is public, so that we can tell it what text object we want to change inside the inspector. Contrast that with the int click count that is not visible from the inspector and is there to keep track of what the int currently is, as well as tell everyone in the scene what the number shown is supposed to be. So now, coming into the graph, let's start with this custom event. The script is designed to be used with a Unity UI button, so it needs a custom event for the UI button to call when pressed. To set this up, go to your newly created button, change navigation to none, and then hit this little plus button. Then drag and drop the object with the script, which is often the button itself, into this object slot. Then click on the dropdown that says no function, and select Udon behavior, send custom event, bracket string. Then come back to your script and copy the custom event name, and paste that into this text box on your button. Now whenever this button is called, it will tell the script to play this event. Anyways, coming back to the script, when this event is called, it comes to this branch node. This node has a networking is owner plugged into it, and will check to see whether or not the player who played this event is the owner of the object. This is done as only the owner of the object can change the value of a synced variable, so unless we are the owner, we can't change what comes afterwards. So, once we've confirmed that we are the owner, it will come to the setClickCount node. This node will look to see what the current value of clickCount is, add 1 to it, and then set that as its new value. Now, when this variable changes, it will play this event. This event was made by coming up to the clickCount in the Variables tab, dragging and dropping it into the graph while holding Alt to get an event that will be called whenever this variable changes. Something to note, however, is that you must checkmark SendChange, otherwise this event won't play. Well, at least not for the owner of the object. Now, as this int is a synced variable, everyone will see it change when the owner changes it. So now, whenever someone sees it change, it will play this event that in turn will play this UI text set text node, and this node will set what text is being shown. For this node, however, first it needs to know what text object to change, so we have plugged our UI text variable into the instance slot. Then, it will need to know what text to display. Now, we have our int variable for our number, but the set text node requires a string value instead. So, we grab a new int value and plug in that through an int to string node to convert it into a string so we can plug it into our text. So now, in summary, when the button is pressed, it will play this custom event. The code will then check to see whether or not we are the owner of the object, and if we are, it will play this node that will add 1 to our int. Then, when everyone sees that the int has changed, it will grab the new value, convert it to a string, and then set our text to be the new number. Awesome! Now, you may have noticed that I avoided talking about this node. This node here is more of a network optimization that also helps with responsiveness. If we look at our button's Udon behavior, we can see this box about synchronization. If we hit this drop-down menu, we can see three different options. None, which will never sync the values. Continuous, which is the default, and it will check the synced variables constantly to see if there have been any changes. I have found in some rough testing for this check to happen 4 to 4.5 times every second, though I believe it throttles to be lower when more things are being synced. And lastly, there is manual. When this is selected, it will only check or update the synced variables for everyone when we tell it to. This means that instead of waiting for continuous to check, we can tell it to update immediately. I also believe it reduces the amount of network calls, but don't quote me on that. Anyways, coming back into our script, this is what the Udon behavior request serialization node is here for. This node, as soon as we change our int value, will immediately tell everyone the new value of the int. This in turn will also make the networking more snappy. And with that, I believe that is everything to the script. So, hope that you found this helpful. Feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials that I have on the channel. But until next time, bye!